The Honourable Member for Fort Garry-Riverview.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise today to pay tribute to those who have rallied to protect the Parker Wetlands in West Fort Garry. For many years, the Parker Wetlands Conservation Committee, a group of local activists, worked tirelessly to preserve this valuable green space. More recently, others have come forward to assert Métis claims to an area once known as Roostertown. Both groups, along with local residents, dog lovers and naturalists, have fought heroically and courageously to save the Parker Wetlands for important ecological, indigenous and recreational reasons. In its natural state, the Parker Wetlands were composed of broad swaths of grasslands and framed by lush woodlands. There were flora and fauna special to our prairie landscape, with well-traveled trails for walking and hiking. In short, it was a beautiful oasis of green space and a much-prized sanctuary away from the travails of modern life. Sadly, Madam Speaker, about a third of the Parker Wetlands were bulldozed this summer, leaving a cold, ugly, cross-cut landscape in its wake. What's more, the situation appears to be going from bad to worse. Recently, the Roostertown activists were removed by court order from the land, the bulldozers have returned, and the fate of what remains of the Parker Wetlands hangs in the balance. And yet many questions still remain. How did an area once designated as ecologically sensitive by the City of Winnipeg become fit for development? How did this designation disappear? And how was it that this once sensitive green space was swapped for a brownfield? And what happened to the RCMP investigation of this land swap? There are many questions, but few answers. What's worse, Madam Speaker, is the Pallister government is complicit in this sad state of affairs. In March of 2016, the provincial government appointed a consultant to review the situation and make recommendations toward a better, more productive outcome. This report has never seen the light of day. I call on the Minister of Sustainable Development to release the report today. It's likely too little too late, but at least we'll know what might have been had the government been open and transparent from the start. Who knows, it might even offer some guidance towards saving what's left of the Parker Wetlands. Well,